What do I feel right now? I feel like an empty goblet. I feel like I want to fill myself with stories, with emotions, with love. But I also feel that emptiness is a shield, an empty barrier between the horrors of this city and my efforts to cling to normality. How does one cope?
Linju, Kaifong, Kinjo no Hito, Jabr, Wazan, Neighbor. What does the word neighbor mean in the context of a densely populated city where some people live stacked upon one another? Someone you awkwardly avoid making eye contact with. Someone who make noises, both pleasant and unpleasant. You just hope they don't leave their trash in a public area overnight. But what if you were suddenly thrown into darkness and your neighbors become your world? I moved into this apartment complex in Central West Shanghai just before the lockdown in April. I had a temporary roommate, and it felt like we were the only real human beings in my little universe. Get up, home test, PCR test. Empty fridge, stuff fridge. Work, cook, Google.
Yo!
Check news on my phone. Breakdown, shower, pass out. This is how my days went in isolation. Then, like every other residential complex in Shanghai, we created a group chat with our neighbors out of sheer necessity. Life essentials had to be ordered in bulk. The neighbors, at first, were just room numbers. But soon, I was able to profile them just based on our group chat. There's a guy above me who can't live without coffee. A young husband in the other building cut his foot one day in the kitchen. The group by leader has some sort of a position at a top university. The piano music comes from a boy on the first floor. Seven cleaners sharing bunk beds in their agency's shop front could really use some food. The rations don't seem to satisfy their needs, or in fact, anyone else's needs. Then, one day in May, a slightly different conversation occurred.
On testing days such as today, we couldn't leave our apartments, but that seems to be, well...
Okay.
Every complex had its own version of lockdown, and by this time, we were allowed to wander around our apartment complex. How should a crew band together? A picnic downstairs, of course. But sitting down with the crowd felt both frightening and transgressive. Would it get us all in trouble? Seeing people felt like stepping into a parallel universe. in which the lockdown never happened, and I was just leading a normal life.
Hello，Hello，
哦，这个是我们的物资吧？这个是我们的那个叫什么鱼片？
油面
鱼片。嗯，
回到那个刚刚贝贝最后一个问题，就是我想要用什么样的方式参与在这个项目里边，或者这个小的片子里边？我是觉得说，可能从我自己能做的那部分比较擅长。
在看到刚刚四月初的时候那一段，就是医护很累啊，然后我会也会觉得很难过，因为我好像没有办法帮助我的同行去做什么。我就想说，是不是有可能我们做一个纪录片，包括我们刚刚开始的时候有一些交换食物啊，然后或者是说哪一位可能食物不够了，然后我们就会有点像众筹的食物给他。我就觉得这个事情是很非常难得的，因为我觉得在这一段时间还有更多的是内心上的一些，就是你会对某些事情可能感到很失望。
但我只是很想要当下就参与进来，因为对于我个人来说，我尽管还不知道如何去评估我所遭遇的，时代中的人们都会经历一些这个时代中的事情嘛。那既然说有经历到的话，还是很希望能够把它转化成成长。
Okay, so this is like an accountof what happened to people who were in the middle of this. That's not a news article, or it's not like, you know, it's a more personal story. And I think that sort of thing.
I'm a videographer, but I couldn't document the turmoil going on. So we picked up our cameras, and time started to move faster. Before we knew it, it was the end of May.And the city was talking about reopening. We even got passes that officially let us go outside. We each sat down to reflect upon the impacts the lockdown had on us.
我觉得我之前其实是属于比较就是精致的利己主义，不太有太多说我去关注到社会面，或者说我关注说哎我的主动去关心邻居的情况，或者说跟他们有很多交流。我不知道为什么，我就在看那个新闻的时候，那个截图的时候，我一下子就心里破防了。我就突然就觉得上海就是怎么了，怎么会让这样的事情发生？封控是一个很特殊的历史性的事件。那大家面对这样一个大的危机之下，负面情绪它其实是一个非常正常的事情，这些情绪是应该被允许的，而不是需要去掩藏它，或者是说我们继续保持曾经的那种岁月静好的状态。
我是小时候出生在这里，所以就是现在还住着有一些邻居是我爷爷奶奶的同龄人，然后有一些邻居是我爸妈的同龄人，就是对有些我其实不好意思，就是完全不认得他们的脸，但他们也会说小时候看着我长大的。我想要社交的时候，我会找自己的朋友，找自己的同事去啊什么的，所以我觉得确实我们过往挺多年就是这样过下来的，那一回才终于把人和头像对起来，结果坐下来以后几分钟吧，就度过了那种错愕，然后就过渡到了哎，就是和朋友们在一起的感觉。
Got used to hearing the sound of the chopping board. Pretty much around 4:15, 4:30, my next door neighbor would always start cutting things. I think it's definitely taught me that a lot of my neighbors have very steady routines. And I think it's good to see that that's something that's kind of held throughout this lockdown, because if you have a routine, if you have certain things that you do at certain times of the day, it's a lot easier to keep focused.There's one time that we received eggplant. My girlfriend shared with me this recipe for a Filipino omelet called tortang, I have to make sure I get this right or she's going to kill me. Tortang talong.
尤其是在中国人讲老话远亲不如近邻的这个事情上，这两个月比较深刻的一个理解。
谁要？
我。
其实在这段时间里面，我跟邻居的沟通远大过我和亲戚朋友甚至是上海之外的家人的沟通，它有一点像是我们共同的一个小小的共同生存体，
反而变成是说你最能够共情和最能够去畅所欲言沟通的一个这样的一群人，因为他跟你处在同样的一个物理空间里边，你们面对同样的一些管控，那所以在这个前提下大家谈论的非常多的政策是可以被理解的。后来有看到其他群别的这些小区只发生过非常非常激烈甚至是说有些谩骂的这些事情，整体的环境还是非常 nice， 算是一个比较友善的小区。
You can put food on the table because of them. Second hand information, real or fake, filters into your feed because of them. When the surroundings don't make sense, you take turns trying to look up what your rights are. You vent, you listenYou ride the emotional roller coaster together. How did I get so lucky to make these connections in this crazy, crazy world? The end was as much of a surprise as the beginning. It was like someone had flipped a switch.
我这两天一直在想，就不管你愿意还是不愿意，时代的洪流已经推着你走到这个时候，我想也没有那么大的能力去改变这个世界或者改变什么，或者至少让身边的人知道有很多事发生是背后有非常大的代价，那这些代价我们如果付出了，我们也希望它是值得的，至少在比如说对于科学、对于病毒的认识、对于其他的认识，
自己加蒜啊、
好。
然后贝贝和我正在做一个 project，
从邻居变成朋友，或者哪怕是说我们可能还是只是像一个邻居网友这样的一个概念，但是我仍然还是觉得挺感激的，因为你会知道在你最艰难的这个时候，你不是一个自己一个人站在孤岛上，就在你身边还有这样真实的人存在，跟你有着一样的情绪，那也跟我有着一样的可能讲不安、恐惧，或者是我希望做一点点小小的反抗、挣扎的时候，有一个人是跟我一样的，他就在你身边，这样传递出来的这个安全感，这个是我觉得在整个的风控阶段里面最珍贵的一个，从邻居身边感受到的一种 connection。
能看得到我吗？
其实我刚毕业的时候，我就来了上海。
所以你没有在美国工作过？
啊，有一些啊。
我其实自己是希望是说有一些目前走得比较近的邻居，在未来可以在生活中去聊天，或者说去，甚至一起可以去坐下喝杯咖啡，或者一起做一些什么事的这种朋友。那我觉得这个部分是对我来说倒是没有什么疑问的。
对，我也不希望因为这件事情以后大家就摒弃了以往的自己选择的生活方式，而变成好像大家都要跟邻里关系怎么样去好，然后你要，我觉得边界感还是要有的，在有余力的情况下尽量把这个好能够让更多的人能够感受到，因为我觉得这个东西你星星之火可以燎原嘛，就不要小看每一个人自己的力量。
Dear neighbors, thank you for saving me in the darkest days of my life so far. I wish we hadn't met like this, but I'm so glad you were there.
来蹭老师的瑜伽课了。